I gotta say, coming up with 50 things right with this one was the easiest task I ever had to do. I wonder if all the next ones are gonna be like this. So, let's not spend too much time on this intro. Unless, have you noticed that if you flip around the thumbnails I've been making up recently, the pictures don't sound that...
Sound. Pictures don't sound. Wow, Rui. You're a genius.
Bad? Why don't you take a print of it? Show it to your friends. Let them know how cursed the Total Drama fandom is. On with this video.
Its premise, Heather's hair. This one is actually my favorite style of the many ones she had. The amount of character development we get straight from the first episode, every character has a moment to shine in such a unique way. Zeke's presence on the plane in every episode is actually pretty cool. I've been watching the first episode for 11 years now, and only recently I've discovered that those creatures are alive, the song they sing. Sometimes they're a nuisance, but analyzing them individually, they are great and just perfectly put together.
If this video hits 500 likes in 1 week, I'll make a top 10 favorite songs.
Scott McCord has always been a great asset to the cast, but I completely became a fan of this man when he said off script, "Monster noises!" I like that they showed them all voting in the eliminations. Team Victory had more heroes in that team than the heroic hamsters. Bridget being stuck to a pole became an icon to this show thanks to this season. Sierra was great this season. Such a creative character with a voice actor that won an award for her role this season. I love the trio of girls between Courtney, Gwen and Heather. They were so powerful together. It's a shame that didn't show off in All Stars even though they had a chance. Aftermaths proved that they had a reason to exist in every of its iterations. The German references were hilarious. Lashana slapping Heather. This season did everything! Sierra's dance. Even if it was a short presence, Noah was great this season. So was Tyler. Lindsay and DJ being so supportive of each other. They know it's hard, but they need each other. They know it's hard, but they need each other. Lindsay hitting her head while leaving. Man, this girl will never cease to make me laugh. Haha, I like how Tyler was such a supportive boyfriend in the hour of goodbye. The Newfoundland challenge was so chilling to watch. I can't explain. It's like they took a break from the competition while competing. The extra clips. Jared, Noah's shade throwing at Chris in Jamaica Me Sweat is priceless. The telethon idea was brilliant. Blainly, in the aftermaths, is great. In all of them. Easy, the hammer, the bomb, hilarious. Courtney and Gwen's brief friendship was one of my favorite things this season. For some reason, Team Amazon turning on Gwen was one of my favorite moments in all this show. Gwen is a loved character, but it only clicked that she is surrounded by all her activators in that moment. Owen winning a gold medal. In Ireland, Courtney stated that when someone is going down, they go down. And Sadie was eliminated because of this. She said the same thing about Gwen, and Gwen literally went down. And that is the thing about World Tour. It's super well written, and it uses so many influences from what Total Drama has done in the past, and no other season does this in the same level. Heather is such a mood in every episode this season. Not evil, but neither good or even neutral. She's just in the middle. The X-Files episode is great. Picnic at Engingdork was broadcasted for the first time on my birthday, and as a birthday gift, Courtney beats Gwen. I wasn't even a big fan of Total Drama at this time. I know I counted the fact that they didn't include IKEA in the Swedish episode as a wrong thing, but man, it totally flew over my head that the fact that they had to build their own boat was an homage to IKEA furniture. Jesus, will this season ever cease to amaze me? The quote, "Get down here and die like a man!" This episode is everything. Jesus! To be honest, I think this is a season that less deserves hashtag justice for Lindsay. The comeback challenge was so great. I forgot this episode when I made my top 10, but I love Niagara Brawls. This season was put together with a lot of cultural care. It's just nice to see. Sierra winning challenges. Good job, girl. Heather's golden tooth stays in her mouth for the rest of the season. I have to commend the artist behind the design for the consistency here. The Hagon challenge with the statues of the eliminated contestants was just another example of how creative this season can be. Planes, Trains, and Hot Air Mobiles was a super powerful episode. Courtney's loyalty to Alejandro is so great and characteristic of her. The finale was so exciting. The extra clip that went all across the globe. I don't know about your country, but extra clips don't usually exist in mine, so I'm glad I got to enjoy it too. Heather being unstoppable this season, and the most important thing, it's Total Drama World Tour. If I wasn't being stingy with my picks, I could have reached 100 things right with this season. I love it so. From both finales being good, from putting the spotlight on Heather, and her being once again a superstar, everything about this season except Gwen and Duncan was immaculate. It's a shame that from here on, this season has left the bar so high that it's practically impossible for the following seasons to live up to the brilliant work that is World Tour, even when they try to work with what World Tour has left for them. Anyway, let's move on to Revenge, shall we?